Welcome back to our special series, PSB 2.0, Reimagining Public Sector Banks. We are now joined by Sanjeev Sanyal, economist, author and advisor in the Finance Ministry. Sanjeev, welcome to the show. Well, let me start with the record of PSU banks appears to be getting worse. The NPAs of private banks as of the third quarter ended December 31 was 4.5% of their total loans, while that of PSU banks are at 14%. The worst private bank NPA ratio is 7.8. The worst PSU bank NPA ratio is 24%. To what would you attribute this rather difficult performance?
I mean, there's been now a, this information you provided is well known and well understood by both the policymakers and the regulator. This is a legacy in many ways of the previous government. We need to separate two issues that are now getting confused. One is the issue of outright fraud, which has, of course, been in the newspapers recently. And of course, nobody has covered themselves in glory on this. We need to look at, obviously, the internal controls of the public sector banks. We need to look at the auditing mechanism. And finally, we also need to relook at the regulation and supervision process. All of that needs to be tightened.
No, Sanjeev, I'm not trying to make this an NPA discussion at all. The reason why I brought up those numbers was only to say that... the banking system was the victim of the same economic slowdown, is subject to the same regulation by the Reserve Bank. And whether it is the coal scam or the spectrum decisions, it affected the entire sector. But the public sector banks have come out looking worse. Even in the fraud issue, the public sector banks are, coming out looking worse. Now, is there something we have to tackle in terms of ownership, governance, management of public sector banks per se?
So I think the issue you're raising is that there is a moral hazard problem at multiple levels. And I think, since you're hinting at it, is there a plan to privatize them in any immediate sense? So let me take that head on and say that there is no immediate plan to privatize these banks. Having said that, it is understood this moral hazard issue that you have raised is a serious one, and we need to tackle with it. There needs perhaps to be a wider public debate about this issue, and not just about ownership, it also about how the regulation of these things work and so on. So I think there needs to be an issue, but as things stand, the issue is being handled. Whatever we do with these public sector banks, consolidation, differential growth strategies, whatever it is, narrow banking, and so on, perhaps even in some cases privatizing, whatever it is, the current immediate effort is the following. One is to tighten up the regulation and supervision of these entities in order to control for all these frauds that you have mentioned. The second issue, and I keep emphasizing this, is that we have this legacy NPA issue for a long time. And we have finally recognized the problem. And we are, thanks to this IBC process, you mentioned, it has been a success, so at least so far. We now need to make sure that the last leg of that gets carried through, and which means that we have to pay attention to the auctioning and resolution process, which, as I said, is now boiling up. So we are in the last leg of it. We need to nail it down and make it work. This is the critical thing. Afterwards, we can get into all these other things. This is an issue that is live, and we need to make it work.
No, I'm not at all denying that that problem is being tackled and tackled very well. But should we not start a discussion whether a government stake needs to be brought down, not privatized, but at least brought down below 50%, which will enable these banks to recruit competitively, reduce administrative layers, and therefore quick decision making?
So, as I said, this is not the immediate plan, but if you're asking me, should there be a debate about it? Absolutely, there should always be a debate about these things. That's how you keep public policy accountable. If there's anybody who is an advocate of feedback-based governance, then I am it. But let me also add here that Let it also, let me give you the other side of it. Mm. There are public sector banks do play many other roles, mm. which cannot be maybe measured mm. In purely profitability terms. There are mm. social inclusion issues. Mm. There are issues, for example, when you did demonetization.
Yeah.
This is not about whether demonetization worked or not. That's the separate debate. Mm. But when you want to do something like demonetization, yeah. again, public sector banks are the key way you carry it out. Yeah. You want to have Jandhan Yojana and other mm. these kinds of things, mm. Social inclusion things. Mm. Again, public sector comes on board.
No,
and you want to go into areas where there's no banking mm. And spread in banking. So there are some roles that public sector banks do play,
yeah.
which private sector isn't burdened with.
Small banks, small finance banks and microfinance are doing a reasonable job in pockets, I agree, on rural lending. The rule currently also is that for every three branches in a bank sector, every bank, not just public sector, even private sector banks, have to open a branch in an unbanked area. You know, there are many ways in which the government has proceeded
in
inclusion. Therefore, will you advise the government to seriously consider bringing down ownership?
Should we? So, well, first of all, there are various ways of achieving. Even if, let's say, mm. we decide that, you know, 70% mm. is way too much for the government to own and you need to. There are several ways of achieving this. One of them is, of course, this can happen organically, i.e. the more efficient private sector banks or foreign banks or whoever mm. they are, mm. Or even NBFCs for that matter, grow faster mm. than these public sector banks, mm. some of them which are under now sort of being, you know, the RBI is directly managing them,
yeah.
as you may know,
yeah.
Currently will be essentially be restricted
PCA,
to some
yeah.
form of narrow banking. So their growth will be restricted and so on. Mm. So there can be one way of going about it is mm. organically let one side grows just mm. by virtue of being more profitable, efficient, etc. Mm. And this balance, rebalancing happens. So that is one way of achieving it. The other ways can be, I'll give you one example.
Mm. Yeah.
You can have, for example, our corporate bond market needs to grow.
Mm.
Okay, it's grown, but it's still quite very lightweight. Mm. And here, the point is, we could seriously begin to think about the frameworks required for it. Mm. One obvious one, where incidentally the government should begin mm. to pay some attention, mm. is to create a much more liquid, risk-free yield curve. And then there is the issue of nationalized and not nationalized. They have, for example, the old nationalized bank, but then you have IDBI, which mm. is a government-owned mm. but not considered a mm. nationalized bank because it functions under a different
act. Yeah.
Act. Mm. So there is a variety of menu of options. So all of these options should be debated
mm.
and the government should consider them and you know, act on them as things go.
No, will IDBI be an experiment for the government?
Well, I'm not in a position to comment. I will let you speculate on that, but my point is a very simple one. Is simply this, that there are many options and combination permutations of things that need to be done
mm.
and can be done. You know, it's not like only one or the other.
No, is there
some
any
combination
is there any
can be done? There are
okay.
many shades of gray in this,
and
it's a combination of these that could be looked at.
No. I brought up IDBI because the government itself, you know, both Arun Jaitley and earlier Jayant Sinha have spoken about IDBI being an experimentation.
I am not in a position to make any announcement on this issue, but I'm just pointing out to you that there are a large menu of options and some combination will be carried out.
Is it at all possible that the government will consider bringing down the stake in any of the public sector banks?
This is, as I said, this is not something we are looking to do immediately.
Okay.
I think the finance minister had also made mm. a comment mm. to that effect.
Mm.
But as I said, a public debate on the matter is always welcome.
Okay.
And we are a feedback-based government.
Mm.
If and when the public debate throws up various interesting options, they will be considered.
All right. Well, let me ask you one final question on public sector bank governance. You know, the BBB experiment was tried, but although that body is a body of august people and they had recommended some very good names as managing directors and chairman, on two occasions, summarily two MDs were removed. And even the boards of those banks were not consulted. So the whole process of empowering the banks, so to speak, got, you know, neglected. Do you think that experiment now has to be revisited? You know, I just spoke to Bimal Jalan on the same issue. And he was, I mean, it was just his idea. Could we have an organization like the UPSC or, you know, even bodies like the CAG and Election Commission enjoy amazing autonomy. Can we think of a body like that which will run public sector banks so that there is, you know, more professionalism in the way they're handled?
See, the BBB experiment is always, with feedback and experience, we can improve upon it. I'm sure there were things which may not have been up to your standards, but, you know, as things stand, we will, you know, if there are obviously governance issues and moral hazard issues that have been discovered, and they need to be fixed, and the BBB has to be a part of that. So whatever needs to be done with the BBB process will be done.
All right, Sanjeev, thank you very much for joining me in this discussion. So quite clearly, government at the moment not looking at reducing its stake in government banks. So that's it on this edition of PSB 2.0. Thanks for watching.